In Movies and Money today, shares of Disney rallied into the release of the hot new film Frozen 2. Movie man Erik Childress is standing by. Hello to you, Erik.
Hi, Angie.
Well, the box office over the Thanksgiving holiday came up a little short of an all-time record, but Frozen 2 did manage to take a new title.
It certainly did, Angie. With over $123 million logged between Wednesday and Sunday, Frozen 2 bested the $109 million record held by The Hunger Games: Catching Fire back in 2013 to become the all-time Thanksgiving holiday weekend champion. This is all the more impressive given that this was the second week of the film's release. So where is that compared to the first film? Well, the film has crossed $300 million in the U.S. this week and is now over $750 million worldwide en route to becoming Disney's $6 billion film released just this year, and they still have the latest Star Wars film on the way in 2 weeks. 85 of that $123 million was just from Friday to Sunday, which meant that this was the 8th highest second weekend in box office history. So we'll track its progress, but it is already more than halfway to the original's worldwide gross of over $1.4 billion, which made Frozen the highest grossing animated film in Disney's storied history.
Not all audiences went out for Disney last week. Many of them actually turned out for some original programming.
And that's the sound of film critics and probably even some regular moviegoers thanking the stars for something that wasn't a sequel, remake, or a reboot. Actually, it was Rian Johnson's murder mystery, Knives Out, that had a very solid start over the holiday, grossing $27 million over the weekend and $41 million going back to Wednesday. Johnson's film is in a position to join some very unique company this year. Amongst the 61 films that have jumped out to $40 million in their first 5 days in November, only four of them failed to reach $100 million. A word of mouth is going to be very strong for this terrific ensemble film, so when it does, it will join just Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, Us, and Hustlers as the only original films of 2019 to cross the $100 million line, and as I said last week, I believe it will kickstart the whodunit genre back into cinemas in a big way. Now, also, while not doing quite as well as I had hoped, word of mouth certainly catching up with A Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood, which dropped just 11% from the previous weekend. That suggests that a total of $60 million is in play for the Tom Hanks Mr. Rogers film, and with a little extra push, possibly even $70 million if people continue to spread the good word.
Erik, my hopes are also high for that Mr. Rogers film, and the documentary is terrific too. Thank you, and see you next week.
Thank you, Angie.
For more Business First AM, check us out on social media. We're on Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter. And go to businessfirstam.com for where to see our show on TV.